Hello everyone. In this video, I will focus on one aspect of my analog multimeter, the Sanwa YX-361TR, and that is the accuracy of its AC voltage measurement. I am not going to test every single one of these AC voltage ranges. I am going to limit my measurements only on the 250 volts AC voltage range, as this is the most common range used by electricians when troubleshooting household electrical problems. I will be measuring voltage on this outlet, which happens to be the most downstream end of its branch circuit. As you know, analog multimeters measure AC voltage by sine wave averaging. For as long as the voltage waveform is a sine wave at a power frequency of 50 Hz or 60 Hz, this multimeter will always give the correct RMS value. But when the voltage waveform is highly distorted, for example from harmonics distortion, or if the frequency is other than 50 Hz or 60 Hz, it will no longer give the correct RMS value. That is, as far as I know, of analog multimeters. In order to provide some context and comparison, I will use as a reference my Hioki CM328601 digital true RMS AC power clamp meter. Among its many advanced features is its ability to connect to a smartphone through Bluetooth and run its app called Genect Cross. The app will enable us to see the actual voltage waveform, the RMS value, frequency, and peak value. And later on, we can also see if the voltage has some harmonics distortion and by how much. I will begin by connecting the clamp meter to the outlet and select the appropriate program function at the Genect Cross app. The app on the cell phone gives 226 volts RMS, 60 Hz, and 299 volts peak. I will now set the range of the analog multimeter to 250 volts AC and connect its test leads to the outlet. Its needle swings to the right to indicate the voltage that it reads. Let us take a closer look. In this position, the needle pointer rests between 230 volts and 235 volts. It's actually closer to 230 volts, around 231. While the true RMS clamp meter is reading 229 volts, the analog multimeter reads around 231 volts. I think that is close enough. And now let us see the harmonics contents of the voltage waveform. I will select a different program function on the Genect Cross app. First, the voltage waveform. So that is the voltage waveform of the input voltage. Let us take a better look at it. It is predominantly sine wave with a bit of distortion. Now let's take a look at its harmonics content. I will use the function called harmonics analysis and select my instrument. I'll change to 600 volts AC measurement and wait for the app to detect the 60 Hz frequency. Now at 60 Hz frequency, the app reports 230 volts AC. The total harmonics distortion referred to the RMS value is 6.71%. While total harmonics distortion referred to the fundamental is 6.67%. The highest harmonics order is the third harmonic order with 6.3% contribution and third harmonic voltage at 14.5 volts. So we can see that even with harmonics distortion up to 6.6%, the analog clamp meter still provides a reading which is very close to the reading provided by a true RMS instrument. While comparing them side by side, we can see that the true RMS meter reads 226 volts, while the analog multimeter reports between 225 and 230 volts. So, taking into consideration the parallax phenomenon, reading the needle, that's about the same reading at 227, 228. And that is very close. From the result of this simple experiment, I can say that the analog multimeter Sanwa YX-361TR was able to match the readings of the Hioki CM328601 within the bounds of the 250 volts AC range, 60 Hz power frequency, and predominantly sine wave voltage waveform. It measured two RMS values in this condition. Although I have not tested the other ranges in the AC voltage measurement function of the YX-361TR, if the result of the 250 volt AC range test is any indication, I believe I would get a similar result within certain conditions. However, since the analog multimeter was designed for sine wave measurement, its accuracy is not specified for any other waveform, especially highly distorted ones. If you're after higher resolution accuracy, an analog multimeter is not for you. You'd best be served by a true RMS digital multimeter. But for very close approximation of true RMS values of voltage waveform, even with THD up to 6%, this analog multimeter is good enough. If you have any comments or suggestions, please comment down below. If you like this, please consider subscribing. Thank you for watching.